Hey everybody, welcome back to another H1Z1 Ignition game. So yeah, let's just start out like any other game on our ATV. You can actually see our detonation spot or landing thing with a helicopter way out in the distance, so that's where we will need to be in about 8 minutes. But yeah, we luckily landed very, very near a town. So we can go ahead and run towards that. Now, I actually forgot to skin up before the game, so we will skin up later in the game once I feel safe and comfortable in some spot and we crash the ATV. But let's keep going towards the town, and hopefully we can find something real nice. I wonder where we need to go. I know there's a couple buildings over here, and I'm gonna grab the truck, obviously, because the truck is a little bit better than ATV. It's kinda slow, it's kinda heavy, it's easy to get shot from still, but of course it's just a giant car, so it's a little bit better. But let's head over to these buildings right here. These types of buildings usually hold an AR or an AK. A lot of times, Lammies, so we do want to get in here. Now, I am terrible with this truck. Okay, I'm about to give up with this truck. This truck is terrible. No, actually, I take that back. I'm terrible. The truck's not terrible. The truck is just fine. But yeah, let's park the truck where someone won't really see it that easily, because, of course, we do not want it to get stolen. And we could actually, like I said before, we could even see where we need to go from the air. So the landing place we need to go is not that far away, so we don't really need to rush our looting. We can take our time, grab what we need, and real quick, let's skin up, because I need to skin up. I don't want to be in the pleb clothes, so let's grab that helmet. And right now what we need is a weapon, and I'm gonna try to grab as many clothing items as possible just for scraps of cloth that we can make into bandages later on. But we found an AR, so that AR will serve us useful. Very, very useful, because now we actually have a chance of surviving. If someone else has a gun and comes in here, I am not going to survive very long. Now, really, what we need now is a piece of armor, a better backpack, which is the tan military backpack, and I guess medical equipment, then we're fine. But that's, like, I just named off practically everything in the game. But yeah, some medical kits would be useful in case I get into some firefights. I should probably grab one more helmet, but oh well. Let's go through this window, see if we can grab anything. So there's some more AR ammo, which we will need, obviously, because if I run out of ammo, that'd not be good. And that Molotov could be useful if we end up in some kind of forest situation. I could throw the Molotov at a tree and burn some dude up. Now, my thing is full. Yeah, it's full of clothing. I should really shred these up and start making them into scraps of cloth and into some bandages. So yeah, let's shred some of these beanies and caps and shirts that I grabbed. That should give us a good load of bandages, at 12 to be precise. Now, that will only make one, procoagulant. If you guys don't know what that item does, it just stops blood flow. It's very quick and easy. It's very useful, though. It does take 10 bandages and a tactical medical kit, so it is quite expensive, but it can save your life. If used wrong, it's a complete waste of materials. If used right, it's completely worth it, and really overpowered if you really know how to use it. But yeah, we do have enough to make it, but only one, so I'm not gonna make it just yet. I think some bandages will be useful if something happens, and of course I do need those medical kits too. But looks like we're not finding much in these buildings. But we have found quite a few medical kits, which is nice. That'll keep us alive. Now, maybe some more ammo would be the most useful thing. Now, I do have plenty of ammo, but having just a little bit more would be nice. There's a sneaky medical kit on the wall right there, and there's an AK. What, that could be very, very useful. I love myself an AK. You guys, if you watched the last, video of me playing Ignition, I did use the AK for a little bit. But yeah, we can pick up this AK and use it. Now, we can throw away a helmet or two. Honestly, I like the look of the motorcycle helmets better than the other one, so I'm going to pick up some of these. Now, I know a lot of people, mainly like the streamers that I watch, actually don't like how the motorcycle helmet looks. They prefer just the tactical helmet, but I don't know. I'm just going to go with the general general consensus and say that I think I like the motorcycle a little bit better. It feels more comfy, feels more protective since it covers my entire head, though it really does not make a difference. But yeah, we still have 3 minutes. Now, we really should head to the safe zone, like I said. If we were super far away from the safe zone, I'd want to loot very, very quickly and get out of here. But since we are so close, I did take my time. You guys saw, we went through 2 buildings, every single level. But yeah, let's head over to the safe zone. Of course, what's even better than looting is killing somebody and taking their body. Because technically, imagine if someone went through 3 buildings and you killed them. Just by killing them, you've got 3 buildings worth of loot. So really, killing people is a way better way of actually looting if you already have a gun. But I'm still fairly, I'm not going to say newbie, but I'm fairly newbie still. I think I've got the aim down, but I guess we'll see. We've got almost 2 minutes until we have to get to the safe zone, but I'm pretty sure that safe zone was very, very close to us. Now, I did, I think, push the time a little bit, but you know what? In the end, I guess we will see. Nobody knows until we get there. Oh, there it is. I actually thought it was a little bit more north, a little bit. Yeah, it's a little bit east, or actually it is east, not a little bit. Alright, there doesn't seem to be very many people in this like valley, hilly area. There could be someone in that house, I'm not sure though. I'm just going to skip by it. I'm not going to stop for no reason. We've still got a minute and a half. So yeah, we can kind of just drive around, see if we can pick off anybody very easily. There are 26 people remaining. This car is decent. It still has half fuel. Its condition is almost perfect, so this car will last quite a little bit. If some dude comes up and magnums my car, we'll even still be fine. Now, I've got on top of the hill. This is a really good bird's eye view, so I'm actually going to stay up here. The only danger I have is if someone comes from behind me, but I'll probably hear them because they'll probably just shoot and be super aggressive. I can actually see a couple people down. There's one person on ATV, one in a cop car. Pretty sure there's another off-roader very deep down. And I'm actually going to wait a little bit. I'm not going to be aggressive. You guys can see that the line or the safe zone is literally maybe 20 seconds in front of us. So I'm going to wait until very low. This hill will give me a lot of speed. And we're just going to go in there last minute because, of course, I don't feel like running around in circles because there are some people shooting down there. So we'll wait to last maybe 30 seconds, 20 seconds. All right, you know what? Let's get going. It's probably going to be close. We could have waited a bit longer, but oh well. Let's get in this so, of course, we're safe. There are 21 people left. There's a big 4-man chase over there. I don't know if I want to get involved, but I'm definitely not hopping out of my car. Because I will get mowed down pretty quickly or run over. But yeah, there's a lot of people around me. This is kind of scaring me. If someone gets out and starts shooting, I do need... There's a guy right there. Okay, I don't know if he was shooting at me or someone else, but I did not get hit, which is nice. Alright, so a lot of people have been eliminated. We have 15 people left. I chose the wrong zone. My zone is very populated. There are shots a little bit everywhere, and it seems to be that I'm getting very lucky because... I mean, obviously everybody sees me, but not a lot of people are targeting me for no reason. That's pretty good. There's a guy down there in the tree. I could go for him, but again, I'm kind of scared to get out of my car. It could be dangerous, and someone's car just blew up down there. Oh, where is this guy? All right, let's try to get... Eh, you know what? Never mind. I was going to say, we probably should get out for that guy, but the thing is, he already had his aim on me, and if I got out of the car, he probably would have killed me, but we can try it again if he's not paying attention. Okay, yeah, he would have had a little bit of an advantage, so I'm not going to take that fight just yet. I know I'm playing very, very passively. Most good players just jump out and kill, but I'm still kind of new, and I'm still trying to be careful. Well, there you can see my newbiness. I put the car in a very, very bad angle where you can just headshot me easily. I'm lucky I didn't die right there. That was the easiest shot of anybody's life. That was... not smart of me, but I managed to survive, so maybe we keep going. But I already, at this point, feel I really don't deserve this win. That was a very big mistake, leaving my car in that angle. But I guess we can learn from mistakes. I had enough to pull out a medical kit and a bandage. There seems to be a dude behind me chasing me. I'm going to wait until I heal up to 100, and now we can fight them. But it seems like those 2 people and off-roaders starting to fight each other, so I'm going to back up a little bit. I'm going to wait until a lot of people die and then maybe pick off the last couple. Again, that's very passive, but I'm going to do what I got to do to win a little bit. There are 9 people left. There's 2 off-roaders to my left. There also is a police car a little bit in front of me that is heading down probably to the safe zone. I can hear some shots up the hills. Got to be careful of those guys. My fuel is running kind of low, down to 35%. That's a little bit dangerous. I probably should grab some more fuel. And yeah, I think, yeah, there's an off-roader there. I probably won't be able to kill him, because if I shoot, he'll just hide right away. But let's see what we can do. Let's see if I can maybe get a hit on him. Oh, okay, didn't. Yep, and he got in his car and he's running away. Yep, that's what I thought would happen. Well, let's get our own vehicle and let's head to the safe zone. We've got about 4 minutes. I don't know if that was a shot. Oh, okay, those were shots at me. The dude has a Magnum and he's shooting at me. Now, if you guys don't know, the Magnums actually do extra damage to cars. And they do about 8% damage to a car compared to an AR, which will do 1 to 2%. I'm pretty sure. I don't know about the AR damage, but I know the Magnum does about 8%, so we do got to be careful of that. My truck is in very good condition, but the better condition, the better in the end game, because if I have to play the duck game hiding behind my car, someone's going to rip up my car open, so I'm going to have to need as much condition as possible just in case. Now we have 3 minutes. We do really have to find the safe zone. I'm already feeling this is probably going to be a very long game. Probably very boring for you guys to watch, but oh well, we will see. We will see. Now, I do have to find the safe zone. I'm pretty sure it's got to be fairly near us, but it might even be above this mountain. Oh no, okay. Up, okay, we need to get our truck. And there goes our truck. That is not good. Yeah, our truck is gone. Well, this is a very, very, very big problem because the safe zone, I'm not saying it's miles and miles and miles away, but it's still very far away. This is going to come down to the wire, and there goes my truck. Boom. Yep, you guys just heard it explode. Now let's try to try our best to find this safe zone. We've got about 2 minutes to get to it. Now, I'm not completely confident we can get there, but it seems to be, yeah, I think we might be on the wrong side of the mountain. 2 minutes might give us just enough time to get there, but I do need to hurry up. Now, the thing about this game is, distance can trick you a lot of times. You guys might think, well, you probably can't go all the way to the mountain, go up it, and go back down in 2 minutes, but really, it's not that far of a walk, so I think I'll make it. I'm pretty confident. Now, we do have a helmet, we do have guns, we do have a molly. We do have a couple medical kits and bandages. The only thing that we're really missing that's going to be super important is armor. I did not grab any duct tape or extra tan bags or shred up any helmets, so I will not be able to make that. That's completely fine. I think we'll try to do our best even without that. Really, armor isn't necessary. Armor is just very useful if you go potato and, like, you can soak one or two shots and you can kill them. If you're, like, good at the game, you don't really need them. Now, I'm not saying I'm good. Probably gonna potato, but I guess we'll see in the end. Now, you guys could tell I'm at the top of the mountain and we still have a minute left. So, yeah, distances in this game can be very, very tricky. Now, there is a safe zone right there. I'm glad we found it. I was kind of scared we won't be able to. Now, we need to get down in that forest quickly. We've only got a minute left. This will be down to the wire. I can hear some shots down there, so I'm going to need to be careful. Yeah, okay. Actually, I can see it, so we'll be completely fine. We have more than enough time to get there. Try to slide down this mountain, get there just a little bit quicker, and hide behind a tree. There are 6 people left, so there are only 5 more people that I need to take down. You can see a truck in the distance there. Is that a second one? I'm getting confused. Well, there is one right there, and he just crashed it into a tree. Pretty sure there's 2 off-roaders. There was one to my left, one to my right. So I do need to be careful. I do need to get in here in the next couple seconds. So yeah, there's a bunch of off-roaders going everywhere. I just need to try to dodge them my best. Yep, there's actually 3 off-roaders. There's 2 to my right, there's 1 to my left. Now, them two are fighting, so I need to be careful. I don't know if I should give away my position and start shooting. I'm not going to give away my position. I'm not going to hit them. There's no reason to. So I'm going to keep my position hidden for just a little bit longer. Just in case. I can maybe find another car because we totaled our truck. It blew up. It's gone. Trucks aren't that nice anyway. I personally really don't like trucks, to be honest. But it was better than an ATV. But if you can find one of these off-roaders, that'd be nice. There's like three or four off-roaders. One of them has to die. Hopefully. But yeah, let's see what we can do. I don't want to move just yet. There's an airdrop over there. People are going to go to it. There is one of the off-roaders. I think he's going for the airdrop. Let's see if we can do anything about it. Let's push up a little bit. We don't want to stay in the same position for too long. There are only four people left. Now, okay, we're actually going to have to go back up the mountain. Oh, there's someone shooting at me. We're actually going to have to go back up the mountain to get to the safe zone. But there's someone over there with a Magnum. You guys can see him crossing. There's probably someone at the airdrop, so we need to be careful of that too. Okay, I'm going to probably take a couple shots at him. Actually, never mind. He's going to drive away. And I think he's probably going to be headed to the safe zone. I think he's just going to peace out of here. He's not going to take the chance. Probably going to play passive. Now, I think that's exactly what I'm going to do. I know there's probably going to be at least one person at the airdrop getting it, trying to look maybe for a hunting rifle, but I'm not going to take the chances. There's actually only three people left, so my prediction is there's one dude going over towards, obviously, the safe zone. There's probably one guy behind me with a car getting the airdrop, and then I'm on the mountain barefoot walking. Now, the thing that scares me is the guy behind me, if he does have a car, he might be able to flank me, but at the same time, he's probably not going to go up the mountain because he has a car. He's probably going to go around the mountain. So I think we'll be fine. But both of them are going to get there first because they both have cars. Obviously, I'm just going to assume he has a car because there's like seven off-roaders. If he doesn't have one of them, then that's just crazy. Now, this might be very, 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 very tight. We have 2 minutes to get to our destination now. This is going to be a very close one. Hopefully we'll make it though. Honestly, so far in this game, I'm really not feeling... I don't feel like I deserve this win. I mean, I'm obviously not going to lose on purpose. I'll take a win if I get it. But I'm not feeling the deserving of this win. Because I've been playing very passively. I haven't killed anybody. I haven't even like looked at anybody. I don't know. And I don't even have a car. I just kind of feel ashamed. I'm kind of just a dude walking around trying to do his best, but I don't really have much. I mean, yeah, if I get a win, I will be happy, but I really don't deserve it. There are probably, out of the 40 or 50 people that were in this match, probably most of them deserve this one more than me, and they just got unlucky. But you know what? If I have a little bit of luck, I'll be okay with that. But we have a minute 30 to get to this destination. Now, it does look pretty far away. But I'm pretty sure we can make it. It'll be very down to the wire. I'm going to guess at least maybe 10 seconds, maybe 15 seconds. So this will be very, very close. And like I said, probably the two people with the off-roaders are probably already there or very close to there. I'm not going to be surprised if I start hearing wheels up ahead of me. Now, the thing that's nice about me not having a car and them two having a car is both of them are very, very, very loud. They will see each other from miles away. I do not have a car. They will not know where I am. So, the likelihood of them two fighting before I get to them is very, very high. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to hide behind a tree or in a bush. I'm going to wait for them two to attack each other. And once one of them's dead, I'm going to go for the last guy. So, at this moment, I don't have much, but I'm going to play with what I have. Now, there are some shots in the distance. And the safe zone is 30 seconds away, and I'm still not there. It's going to be close. But yeah, hopefully I can use my silence to my advantage, or my not carness to my advantage. Them two already know where they are, and they're already exchanging shots, which is a good thing. Now, the only problem is I only have 10 seconds to get down there. Oh, guys, I might blow up. 3, 2, 1. Guys, that was the closest I've ever been. That was actually insane. So, okay, there's two cars over there. So, yeah, both of them are in off-roaders, like I said, and they're both chasing each other. Now, I do not want to give away my position, of course, because, like I said, the game I'm trying to play here is the stealthy game. And I gotta really be careful. See, this guy could probably shoot, but I'm gonna not do it just yet. I do not want to give away my position, because I'm still waiting for one of them to die. So let's see what we can do about this. It doesn't look like either of them saw me, because they're probably too focused. Now, that's a very clear shot for me. Alright, one has died. Let's see if I can hit him. And I potatoed both shots. The great thing is, one of them has died, so it is a 1v1. Now, my advantage of them not knowing where I am and me dropping is very much gone. Now, I have a kind of a big disadvantage. It's a guy in a car versus me, who I will have to head over there. He's alright, because he's in a car and he has a very fast vehicle, so I'm in the disadvantage, but hopefully I can still beat him. We will see, but yeah, those two shots, if you guys look at the replay, they're, okay, hold on, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and bam, his advantage is gone. If you guys saw, he actually threw his car away. He single-handedly threw his advantage away, which is nice of him, just giving me a gift of a free win. But yeah, guys, what I was saying is, when I was trying to shoot at that guy with the two bullets, my aim was on him. The shots just didn't hit. So I don't know what's going on there, but right there, yeah, he just potatoed. He only hit me once, I'm pretty sure, and he threw his car away. He had no cover. The animation to get out of the car was just enough for me to hit him a couple times, and yeah, there is the win, guys. Not very proud of it, but a win is a win in this game. So guys, if you guys enjoyed that, make sure to like and comment as it supports my channel, and I'll see you guys later. God bless, and goodbye.